Okay. Yeah, thank you for kind introduction. Yes, deep impression is my research always. So today, let me introduce a small story of the impression received from the three papers. Okay, as past two decades, we have concentrated on electroactive function cultivation in a transparent oxide. This view graph summarizes three highlights. One is a glassy amorphous semiconductor, which is now it's productive. It's a mass production started from the bed as different countries. So the iPad Air or the smartphone and OLED TV, 55 inches by LG display. And the second is a cement material, calcium aluminate. This material can be converted into a transparent metal and superconductors. And also we are now concentrated on catalyst for ammonia synthesis. And the last one is ion-based superconductors. This material was discovered in the course of the improvement of the P-type transparent oxide. Yeah. So that each of them started from the impression received from the three papers. Okay, so what is the ultimate goal of my research? So my research objective is to create a new global material research trend. I don't catch up to anyone. Please follow me. This is my trend. So that I have three dreams, three beyond. One is as amorphous semiconductor beyond the amorphous hydrogenated silicon. The second is the superconductors with high TC, TC higher than the cuprates. And the last one is ammonia catalyst as beyond the Haber-Bosch process. These three are my goal. So that I become 60 years old, so that I have no reason to flatter the senior guy. I have already have a funding, no safe to the retirement age. So that I want to say what I want to do. Okay, that's first is as amorphous silicon case. When I was an undergraduate, so that this paper has appeared in the Solid State Communication. So that this is title is a substitutional doping of the amorphous silicon. The silicon is of course the king of the semiconductor, but the amorphous silicon was almost impossible to dope carriers. But this paper is the report that the PN control by intentional control by the glow discharge process. So that also the Walter Spear and Peter Lecombe, Dundee of the UK. Okay, this paper was first submitted to PRL, but rejected, no physics. Always, as the reviewer said, no physics. So the, yeah, after that, they resubmitted the paper to a solid state communication. So that this paper has gave a huge impact because it's this is the history of the amorphous semiconductor. The history of the amorphous semiconductor is almost comparable to the crystalline semiconductors. And the impact of the amorphous silicon discovered by the Spear and Lecombe has opened a new huge market called giant microelectronics. Giant microelectronics means that the electric circuit fabricated on a large size of the glass. Now the main field is of course the display. The market size of the display is approximately $100 billion, almost comparable to the automobile industry. So that such a huge market is supported by amorphous hydrogenated silicon, discovered by Peter Lecombe and Peter Lecombe and Walter Spear, 1975. So after that, so from the 2000, and so next, what's next? So the flexible electronics. Flexible electronics means that the electric circuit fabricated on the plastics. So that But what kind of the semiconductor is needed? So that many people say that organic. Yes, yeah, I don't think so. Inorganic is much better. So that's why we focus on amorphous oxide semiconductors. Okay, this is a structure of the LCD panel. So that a backlight is here. You can see that each pixel from here. So that when has voltage is applied and the LCD is self-operated, so that you can see that light pass through that liquid crystal cell. So that the switch corresponding to control the property of performance of the display, so that the role of switch is due to the thin film transistor, like here. Amorphous silicon is used here, okay? But the amorphous semiconductor, amorphous material has a huge process advantage, that is to say, and you can easily obtain the homogeneous thin film. But the electronic transport property is pretty bad. So that this case, I'll show that example. So this is a case of the silicon, and it's a covalent type semiconductor, a traditional compound semiconductor, is always like this. So that this is a case of the N-type silicon, so the mobility is 200. When silicon becomes amorphous, what happens? Maximum mobility drop to order of magnitude. The maximum is one. So that people believe that amorphous semiconductor has a process of advantage, but the electron transport is pretty poor. So that this is true for the gallium arsenide and its indium arsenide. But if you change the view from the tetrahedral system to the oxide, the situation becomes totally different. This is my guess, and I proposed this concept in 1996. So the heavy metal oxide. So the oxide is the ionic system. So the bottom of the conduction band, which works as an electron pathway, is primarily composed of the vacant s orbital for these oxide. If the vacant s orbital has a special split, and such a case is direct bonding between neighboring s orbital is possible. Okay, so please remember the string composed of the metal ball, almost like a pachinko ball. So the stretched state corresponding to the crystal, while the holded state is corresponding to the amorphous. So that you make easily understand that the holded state and the stretched state, so the conductivity doesn't change so much. Or if this condition satisfied. By using this simple idea, we explore that the various material. Okay, so presented this concept at the 16th Amorphous Semiconductor Conference held at the Kobe. At the time, this year, it's a big earthquake attack in the Kobe at the time. At this conference, more than 800 papers are presented. But the oxide, amorphous oxide paper is only one. Okay? And I wrote this proceedings paper. So this paper is not so well cited until the 2/4. Four times cited. So the 2/4 are self-citation. But after that, so many people are following these papers. So I show that this view graph. So this is a periodic table. If you choose these elements, and so you can obtain that the large electron mobility amorphous oxide semiconductors. Okay, so many combination. Okay, so we show that only one, maybe three. In indium gallium zinc oxide, people call the IGZO is the only example of the transparent oxide semiconductor, amorphous semiconductor with high electron mobilities. Okay, and so this is a TFT fabricated by indium gallium zinc oxide. So the deposits on the plastics. Okay, so that the field of effect mobility of the exo is 15. 15 means that the 30 times higher than that of the amorphous hydrogenated silicon. Okay, well, of course, it's a glassy semiconductor is pretty poor. Okay, and the homogeneity is pretty good. Okay, so the why is that many people ask me, amorphous silicon people ask me, why your amorphous oxide semiconductor shows that the large mobility, something strange. Okay, and but I'll show that as a reason. Okay, this is a amorphous silicon case. This is conduction band bottom. This is the valence band top. Our family is located here, so the two worker as a TFT family level should be shifted and from here to here. If the as the family level exceed the conduction band minimum, so the band conduction occurs. But and the amorphous silicon case, so many tail state density, 10 to the 21st at this position. On the other hand, exo cases, federal located here, so that the tail state density around here is 10 to the 18th. So the three order less. That's why we can easily upshift the frame level from here to the bottom of the conduction band. As a consequence, bad conduction occurs. Amorphous silicon case, band conduction doesn't occur due to the presence of the large and tail state density. So this is material nature. We are not so clever, okay? But the material is much cleverer than we expected. Okay, so that, oh. Yeah, this is the current status, and so we, publish a paper, crystalline semi-exo and amorphous exo, and it's from 2 years before, and application started for iPad and mobile phone is like this. I don't recommend to buy this one, but anyway, and from as last year, 55 inches OLED TV with 55 inches started. iPad mini is also driven by exo TFT. So that the first the target was cleared. The problem is the next. Next is quite difficult. Okay, so the second is the superconductors. Yeah, so I intentionally and so avoided to do the superconducting research because the superconducting area is so busy. And the superconducting research area is a primary domain of condensed matter physics. Okay, I feel that there's no space to keep originalities. That's why I intentionally avoided this subject. But in 2005, I encountered this paper by Bob Carver of the Princeton University. He's a chemist. Okay, so paper is quite interesting. This is a 40th years anniversary issue of the chemical communication. Okay, the superconductor is not so rare. So the 205 material is discovered per year. So the most interesting here is the search for the new superconductor has largely been the domain of condensed matter physicists knowledgeable in the synthesis of the intermediate intermetallic or the oxide compound. Chemistry has much to offer the field, okay? And also this sentence, I love it. So that if concentrated on the search of the new superconductors, so you will find that another interesting material. I completely concur with Bob's opinion. So from here, I determined to join superconducting research if we have possible pair of material. Okay, so that's, this is fundamental. So the superconductivity is compete with the long range spin ordering. So that because that two have a superconducting state, formation of the Cooper pair is absolutely needed. So on the other hand, the magnetic ordering means that each spin has fixed one direction. So the long-range spin ordering is much stronger than the formation of the Cooper pair. That's why the magnetic element is pretty bad for the for emergence of the superconductivity. So that's the iron, cobalt, nickel. This is a typical magnetic element with large magnetic moment. Iron is a typical example. That's why the iron-based superconductor, and when we reported the iron-based superconductors, people were very surprised. Okay, this is the first paper on iron-based superconductor that appeared in 2006, and it's 2008. This is most cited paper, more than 5,000, just one papers. Okay, so that's I don't explain the detail, but anyway, first we submitted this paper to Science, but Science rejected this paper without reviewing. Okay, this is the real story. But at the end of that year, this paper was selected as a breakthrough of the year, 2008. Okay, so don't believe that it's an editorial of the Science. Yeah, so the amorphous silicon case is almost the same. Yes, physics regulator rejected that paper, no physics. Okay, this paper is also. Okay, to our surprise, 2 or 3 years ago, as superconductivity has reached the 100th anniversary. At that time, the Nature issues a special issue. This is the account article, Still in Suspense. So from the 1911 to the current state, current age, so that they pick up the 10 milestone as event. So that's it. This is a superconductivity bar discovered by Camaleones and BCS and Woodstock of the superconductivity and the March meeting of the APS. And to our surprise, this paper is cited almost comparable to the this is George and Alex Mueller. Okay, but this paper was rejected by Science. Okay, it's, this is the current the hot data we published. Okay, so that when the key of the superconductivity in iron-based superconductor is doping. Doping to the antiferromagnetic metals. So the parent phase is here. So when an electron is doped, the antiferromagnetic ordering disappears, the superconductivity come out. So we first use fluorine. But after that, so that we replace fluorine with H minus. H minus is our favorite. So that we're very surprised that this is, at first, people believe that this is the first dome of dome is here. After that, this is nothing. But in reality, there is a two dome. And also the parent phase of the this dome is here, and second dome is much larger and much higher TC. And it's the responsible parent phase located here. And the magnetic structure is totally different. Okay, so that someone said, you should find a three dome around here. I don't guarantee. But anyway, it's, yeah, 日本語曰く, 一山越えたらもう一山あったと。 多分もう一山あるでしょう。 Yeah, please anticipate the next challenge. Okay, so the, as many people, especially Chinese physicists, say that the superconducting research has entered the new age, that is to say, from the Bronze Age to the Iron Age. But I don't believe. But let me back to the Stone Age from here. So Stone Age. Okay, as calcium aluminate is my favorite material, and so when an electron is doped to this cement material, this sample shows that the metallic conductivity. Okay, the metallic sample is cooled down. What happens? Superconductivity appears around here. This is superconducting cement. and the volume fraction of the superconducting phase is 100%. Okay? This is quite interesting. Okay. Yeah, when we published a paper on the cement superconductors, it's quite interesting paper, account appeared in the Nature 204. At the time, heavily adopt silicon becomes superconducting. At the time, Bob Cover and submitted a law to this news and view articles in Nature. Superconductivity is not so rare case. It's eventually it's even the silicon becomes superconducting. But and he has ended as this article by describing this sentence. If that the superconductor is made by doping concrete, I don't know, it's time for me to retire. Okay, so that I found this paper, so that I sent the email to Bob. So the, December 31. So that I left my lab, it's almost 12 o'clock at midnight. The almost 30 minutes from my lab to the, my house. So that when I reached my house, I opened the email. So that the Bob, I received the email from Bob. That is absolutely correct. Okay, but I cannot retire because my daughter is still undergraduate. This is a real story. Okay, so that's the last one is electron. So that I love the electron. Electron is a compound in which electrons work as an anion. So the first electrolyte was reported by James Dye, Michigan State University. His motivation is quite interesting. He was fascinated by color when alkali metal was dissolved in the liquid ammonia. Pretty clear blue color, and sample becomes conducting, metallic conducting. So he wanted to have a crystal of the sorbated electron. And eventually he idealized the electrolyte by using chrome ether. But the fatal drawback of the organic electrolyte is pretty unstable. When sample was exposed to the ambient atmosphere, easily damaged. So that the even liquid nitrogen temperature, when sample was exposed to the oxygen or the humidity, sample is easily degraded. So that how to synthesize a room temperature stable electrolyte is a long-standing issue since the discovery of the electrolyte in 1983. We succeeded in synthesizing the room temperature stable electrolyte by using a C12S7 cement material. This is a C12S7. Okay, so this material is stable. Okay, but this material has the most unique property of this material is lower function. Work function of this material is almost comparable to that of the metal potassium. But this material is chemically stable. We can touch by hand. This is totally different from the lower function metals. So I saw that this material is a pretty good opportunity to apply to the ammonia synthesis. Yeah, I determined. So first, I asked the graduate student to check the surface structure by using STN. But this is cement material, no cleavage, no clear cleavage. My collaborator said that this is impossible, that this is a cement material, no cleavage surface. Why you choose this material to observe the STM observations? But without observing the STM picture, almost impossible to apply. So the, yeah, the, if we fail the ammonia synthesis, many people say the surface is a problem. So that to avoid such a possibilities, we have to clarify the surface structure by STM. So after a struggle of 3 years, we succeeded such as a clear STM picture. So this picture means that the surface structure is almost like a bulb. And so even up to the uppermost surface, and such as cage structure is retained. If we carefully choose the reconstruction conditions, and as we apply the ammonia synthesis. So as you know, that the ammonia is pretty important. So the almost 100 years ago, more than 100 years ago, human being had faced with the starting because it's an active nitrogen source has become decreasing. Okay, so that's how to obtain an active nitrogen for production of the fertilizer was a social issues. At that time, as Karl Bosch, as Fritz Haber of the Karlsruhe Technical University invented the chemical synthesis using nitrogen from air and hydrogen. But operation condition is too hard, especially the high pressure. But most of people abandon, but only Karl Bosch, who would become a president of the bus, and accepted this as a difficult process. And eventually, they succeeded. This is now called the Haber-Bosch process. Okay? Haber-Bosch process is a process which was contributed to the to prevent the starving from the human being. Okay, but the critical issue is a huge energy assumption, 1% of the total energy. Okay, so how to reduce high pressure is very critical. So we consider that this material is much better, so that we loaded the lithium nanoparticle on the C12SM and it's checked the catalytic properties. So the turnover frequency is one order higher and activation energy is almost half. Yes, pretty good. Almost time, I'll show that the demonstration of the and our catalyst. So this is the ambient pressure ammonia synthesis. Yeah, okay, so the two avoid the misleading. We place the stopwatch, okay? So this is real time. So when ammonia is produced, the liquid become lead due to the phenolstrane, like as a junior high school chemical lab. So you can see that the formation, efficient formation of the ammonia at ambient pressures. Almost time, too quick, okay. This is very beautiful. Okay, so the last is a message from, but I'm still young, okay? But so I have no afford to give a real message to the undergraduate student. We have to compete with you. Okay? So this is official message, all or nothing is incorrect. All or something is true. If you as truly concentrated in the new material research, as material research is much more exciting than you expect. This is always true. Thank you very much.
Thank you.